When you're citing the title of a source using the MLA citation guidelines, there's usually a few steps that you want to take to make sure that you do it accurately. The first step is simply to find the title. So compare the cover of the book, the title page, and also the publishing information, and try to pick the title that seems best formatted, that seems most accurate. And what we've done here is we've simply taken these titles, we've plunked them in, and now we need to do some editing. So the second step is to watch out for subtitles. And if you have a subtitle, as we do here, then we can typically add a colon. So in this case, we already have a colon over here. One of them is done already. And further down, we have a colon before Recovering Arcadia. So in that case, that's the subtitle. And finally, we have one here as well. If there is no colon on the original title page, you can still add the colon in your works cited. The third step is to fix the capitalization. And as you can see from the first one here, for some reason we have this odd S that has crept in, so we want to fix that. But beyond that, there are some specific rules to follow when you capitalize. In particular, smaller words, less significant words, don't need to be capitalized. And so if we go through this, we see, for instance, that in this case, the word a, that's an article, doesn't need to be capitalized. But the, even though it's an article, it comes after the colon, and so it starts a new section of the title, that one does need to be capitalized. In the second one here, and does not need to be capitalized, it's a coordinating conjunction, and we don't have to add the capital there. And then in the last one, all of this does not need to be capitalized. Just because it's like that in the original source doesn't mean that you have to do it as well. And if you look at the rest of this, we can see that late is an adjective, to and now are adverbs. These are capitalized, whereas the smaller words like of, that's a preposition, and the article, are not capitalized. Notice again, though, that we have the after the colon, and so we do add the capital. The last thing is to figure out if we need to use italics or quotation marks or both for our title. Shorter works are typically placed in quotation marks, whereas longer and more independent types of works tend to be in italics. And I use the word independent because shorter works are often included in longer works. Now, if we look at this then, the first one is an article in a book, and so we're going to use quotation marks at the very beginning and at the very end. There we go. Also, in this case, we're referring to a film here, so we're going to place this in italics. A film is a longer work. And then if we were very careful, we would notice that in the original, this is also italicized to draw attention to that word. So we might as well keep that as well. Then we have the second one, and this one is quite tricky. Because it's a book, we would first start by italicizing the whole title. But then because we have titles of books within a title of a book, this gets a bit messy, we're going to make sure that the titles themselves are not italicized. So in this case, we're going to keep this regular. Now that looks a little bit awkward, looks a bit strange, but that is how you would do it. And then the last one here, this is much easier. This one is simply the title of a book, so we can italicize the whole thing. Hopefully that gives you a sense of how you can cite the titles of works using the MLA citation guide.